I used to be 14 in the crib, tryna be a trap nigga. Now I got me some floor seats at the game, tryna go bat nigga. Got me feeling like Spike Lee on the wood, smoking on Pat nigga. Drunk texting my wifey, so I know I'll get a text bat nigga. 45 on my white tee, used to have this shit up on the dash nigga.
Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's your boy Skillsy Man coming at you with a brand new video, man. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing y'all how you can do this glitchy spin dunk on NBA 2K21, man. I got a hand cam and everything. This is gonna be a banger video. But before we get into the video, man, I wanna give a quick last shout out to my boy FastXO for letting me use his account to record this tutorial. I am using his account because I have a playmaking shot creator on NBA 2K21 and I will not be getting dunk animations off of this move. I will still be able to do the move, but I won't be able to get nice cool looking dunk animations. So I want to use his account. And also, man, go make sure to check out his Twitter or some sort of social media. I'll link it in the description. And also, y'all, make sure y'all hit that sub button before we get into this, because a lot of y'all are not subscribed to me who watch my videos. So make sure y'all subscribe, make sure you hit that like button, and without further ado, let's get right into the video, man. So this move is very, very simple, man. So what you want to do is, the first step is you want to be holding R2. Go either right side or left side or even the middle, but the middle is a little bit more tricky, okay? So go left side or right side, and you want to hold R2. And what you want to do is go, but while you're going right side or left side, you just want to hold R2, and with the right analog stick, you want to go from 12 o'clock to 3 o'clock, man. So look at my hand cam right there. Look at my controller. Like, as you can see, when I went for that, I went from 12 o'clock to 3 o'clock. Okay, for some reason, some people don't know what that means. I'm gonna show it to you right here. Okay, so as you look, as you can see, I go from 12 to 3 o'clock. And if still that doesn't make sense to you, I'm gonna put up a picture of a clock on this screen and show you what I mean. From 12 to 3, it's a bit maybe past 3, but it's like around 3 o'clock, okay? And I'm showing it with my controller right now as well. So as you all can saw what I just did, you go from 12 to past 3, just look at the hand cam, just like that. And you want to be doing that while you're holding RA2. So it's kind of tricky to get it down, but you can get it down, okay? Once you get it down, it becomes super, super simple. And I also have I put up a picture of the clock earlier to show you guys how you can do it, okay? It's super simple. Go from 12 to 3 and you will be able to do it. And just a disclaimer, sometimes you will get layup animations, sometimes you will get weird hook animations, and sometimes you will be double spin off of your defender. You do like one spin and you'll do another spin, but that will only happen if they play really good defense, and which most people won't be able to do, because nobody's expecting you to do this move. And also on top of that, the only time that will happen is when an AI is guarding you. The AI guard this move perfectly, okay? And you can get some crazy, crazy, crazy animations with this. And it's crazy, man. And as y'all just saw, it's the same exact thing on the left side, but of course you do it on the other way around. You go from 12 to 6, I believe. I'm pretty sure that's how you do it. But y'all saw how you do this, man. This is a tutorial on this move, man. And I'm also gonna show you guys the build that I'm using, because this is a demigod build that I'm using, okay? You can do this move with any build, but this build that I'm using is a super fun build to use, and it's also a comp build, okay? This is a comp build that you can get glitchy with, okay? I'm telling you right now, this is a center, and y'all see how quick I'm moving? So I'm gonna show y'all the build now. Alright, before I show you guys how you make this build, I'm gonna show you this build, the stats of this build at 99 overall. And as you can see, I'm a power forward but play center with this build. And look at those stats: 99 standing dunk, a 93 driving dunk, 90 close shot, 75 driving layup. And then look at the defensive stats: 99 defensive rebounding, 99 offensive rebounding, 99 block, 85 steal, 85 lateral quickness, 85 perimeter defense, and 80 interior defense. And on top of that, you have a 71 passing accuracy. So you can literally throw focal passes after you get the board. This build is super glitchy, man. Now I'm going to show y'all how to make this build. So let's jump straight into the build part of this video. Alright y'all, now I'm going to show you guys how you can make that demigod build, which will give you the animations that you need to do that glitchy spin dunk. Of course, it's like a million builds that can get contact dunks with that build, with that move. But I'm going to show you guys the build that I use in this tutorial. And this is a demigod build, and it's one of the best builds. So, you know, it's a win-win for both sides. So, you want to make him a power forward. Right-handed or left-handed, does not matter. Jersey number does not matter. But this matters. You need to subscribe to me to keep watching this video, man. So we're going to continue now because everybody's subscribed, right? So now we are going to scroll down and we're going to pick the pure red pie chart. Okay, we're picking the pure red pie charts. And for your physicals, we're going to go ahead and pick the speed pie chart, okay, because strength does not matter on this game whatsoever. Now you're gonna go ahead and max out your close shot, max out your driving layup, max out your driving dunk, max out your standing dunk, and that's it, okay? You can max out your post to get 18 finishing, but you don't need 18 finishing. 16 is good enough. Then you max out everything in defense. Everything in defense gets completely maxed out. Alright, so once you have done that, you will get 30 defensive badges, then you have 71 left. You can put in your free throw if you would like, and try to, you know, this is if you play program, you can put in your free throw and have a free throw, right? But we're not gonna do that, okay? We're not gonna do it. We're gonna get some more badges. We're gonna max out the passing accuracy and the post moves, and then max out the ball handling, as well, put 10 into ball handling, and then you will get 5 playmaking badges as well, man. So now your body type does not matter, but we're gonna go with build just to look nice. For your height, you can go we're gonna stay at 6'9", but you could also go with 6'8". 6'8" will be fine, but we're gonna stay at 6'9". For the weight, we're gonna go minimum weight, okay? We're going minimum 190, and that's it. Wingspan, we're gonna max it out, and look at those stats, man. So as you can see right now, you have 82 speeds. Is 82 speed, but once you're at 99 overall and you have the Gatorade boost, you will have 90 speed. 90 speed on a center, okay? And rebounding on rim takeover does not really matter. We will go with rim takeover because that's what my boy Fastix so took. And now you have built a glass cleaning finisher. Well, now I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys the badge setup that my boy Fastix so runs, okay? This is the setup he runs, and I'm gonna just show it to you guys. Hopefully I get the setup right. So I believe he runs hollow, a gold contact finisher, gold consistent finisher, gold lob city, gold putback boss, gold relentless, and then bronze slithery finisher. I think this is the bad setup my boy Fastix so runs, and he's a great center. So, you know, I would trust him with the badges he has put on, and this is a great badge setup. Then for your shooting, he has slippery alpha, but of course your shooting does not really matter, but you're inside center. Then for the 5 playmaking, you want to put on gold quick first step, bronze unpluckable, and bronze break starter. But of course, if you're playing twos, don't use break starter because it won't help you. And put on bronze unpluckable, even bronze needle threader. So this is a bad setup for the playmaker. And then you have 30 defense. We're gonna go ahead and put on Hall of Fame box, Hall of Fame hard crusher, because this badge is overpowered on this game. Hall of Fame rebound chaser, Hall of Fame rim protector, Hall of Fame brick wall, Hall of Fame intimidator. Then you have 6 badges left. You can put on Hall of Fame interceptor, then bronze chase down, and bronze warm. This is a great setup. Or you can even do this, have silver pogo stick. I think this is the setup he actually runs. I could be wrong, but this is what I would run. I don't know if this is what he would run, but this is what I would run. This badge setup looks very, very, very good. I definitely recommend it. And this is the end of the video, man. I've showed you guys the build that will get these contact dunks, but of course there's a million builds I can get it. So this is not the only build that can get it. And also, I showed you guys how to do the move with hand care. And this is the end of the video, man. If you made it this far, thank you so much for watching the video to the end. And if you like the video, please be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you're new. Links to all my social media will be in the description. And peace out, y'all.